गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 10th, वेलकम टू सोशल साइंस क्लास वंस अगेन। आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड योर एग्जाम आई थिंक वेंट वेरी वेल एंड यू ऑल स्कोर गुड इन दैट। सो फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल मूव ऑन टू अवर सेकेंड टर्म सिलेबस फॉर द मंथ ऑफ फ्रॉम द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर टू जनवरी एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द लेसन फ्रॉम द बुक Political Science Book, Lesson Number 6, Political Parties in India. This is one of the very interesting lesson and we have read this in class 9th also, the introduction part and some important topics of this lesson we discussed in class 9th also. So in this chapter we will cover the topics, why do we need political parties, how many parties should we have, national parties and state parties, challenges to political parties, and how can parties be reformed. So these are the five topics we will cover in this chapter. Now the very first question is, what are political parties? There are three main components in this: leaders, active members, and followers, and their functions and the necessity for the to make a political party. So let's first of all we will discuss what are political parties. A political party is a group of people who come together to contest elections and hold power in the government. They agree on some policies and programs for a society with a view to promote collective good. A political party has three main components. What three main components a political party has? First, the leaders. A political party must have a solid or strong leaders. Second, the active members. And a political party must have some active members who participate in the different activities. And third main component is the supporters. So these are the three main components for a political party. Now, what are the functions of the political parties? Parties contest elections. Second, parties form and run government in country. The political party which will win in the election will run the government of a country. Parties put different policies and programs. You all are very well aware of this, that parties put on some policies and programs in favor of the people and just approve those policies and programs. Parties play a decisive role in making laws for a country. And when some laws are made, that is the main, a political party plays a very important role. Those parties that lose in the elections play the role of opposition to the parties in power. Without a solid opposition, a ruling party becomes sometimes dictator. So a strong opposition party should be there. Next, parties shape public opinion by raising and highlighting issues. Yes. Parties raise our opinions or highlights issues. Parties provide people access to government machinery and welfare schemes implemented. So these are the main functions of the political parties. What a common Indian think about political parties? Now this is a very important view we should know, that what a common people think, what a common Indian think about political parties. Most people in India tend to be very critical of political parties. They blame parties for all the wrong with our democracy and our political life. The parties were also identified with social and political divisions in our country. This is the general view of a common people. Next, why do we need political parties? This is a very important question. Like, why do we need political parties? We can understand the necessity of political parties by imagining a situation where political parties does not exist. Every candidate in the elections will be independent. So no candidate will be able to make any promises to the people about any major changes. The government may be formed, but its utility will remain ever uncertain. Elected representatives will be accountable to their constituency only. No one will be responsible for how the country will be run. So this is the reason why, what is the need of political parties? Yeah, why do we need political parties? This question may come in some other form. Imagine a situation without political parties in the country and describe it. One more other form of this question is why modern democracies cannot exist without the political parties. So we can understand the necessity of political parties by imagining a situation without parties. Elected representatives will be accountable to their constituencies for what they do in the locality, but no one will be responsible for how the country runs. What other function parties do? Parties inform people about the working of the ruling party, because our elected representative make us inform about the functioning of the party. They keep people informed about the political activities. Political parties talk about the failure in the ruling party and suggestions for the upliftment of the masses. Political parties maintain their contact with the common people. They act as link between the government and the people. That is the reason we find political parties is in almost all countries of the world, whether these countries are big or small, old or new, developed or developing countries. One more important question in this is, state the various functions political parties perform in a democracy. This is an NCERT question. It is also in your book. The other form of this question is, explain the importance of political parties in modern democracy. So answer of this question is, the political parties perform various functions in democracy, like parties contest elections. Second, parties put forward different policies and programs. Parties make laws for the country. Parties form and run government. Parties play the role of opposition to the parties in power. Parties shape public opinion. Parties provide people access to government welfare schemes. So these are the important functions. What are the characteristics of political party? This is also an NCERT question. It is also very important. What are the characteristics of a political party? The characteristic of a political party are, every party has a certain structure. The group of people is organized in a proper way. Every member is aware of his role and responsibilities in the party. All the members agree in some policies and programs for the society with a view to promote the collective good. Political parties reflect fundamental political divisions in society. So this is the characteristics of political party. Now, different party systems in the world. Single dominant party, two political parties. In one party system, one political party is legally allowed to hold effective power. Although minor parties may sometimes be allowed, they are legally required to accept the leadership of the dominant party. This party may not always be identical to the government, although sometimes positions within the party may in fact be more important than positions within the government. And the China is the example of this. Two political parties. Two party systems are stars, such as United States of America, in which there are two political parties dominant to such an extent that electoral success under the banner of any other party is almost impossible. One right-wing coalition party and the left-wing coalition party. These are the two political party systems. And other is multiple political parties. A poster for the European Parliament election 2004 in Italy showing party list. Multi-party systems are systems in which more than two parties are represented and elected to public office. Australia, Canada, Pakistan, India, Ireland, United Kingdom, and Norway are examples of countries with two strong parties and additional smaller parties that have also obtained representation. The smaller or third party, parties may form a part of a coalition government together with one of the larger parties or act independently from the other dominant parties. More commonly, in case where there are three or more parties, no one party is likely to gain power alone, and parties work with each other to form coalition government. These are the topic we will cover today, and in the next video we will continue with the next part. So I hope you all will understood, you all have understood this topic very well. And please try to watch this video twice or thrice to for the better understanding. I have seen that you have not so very regular in watching the videos. So please, I request you all to watch this video to understand this lesson or chapter. And I will provide you the notes of the same in the next video. Thank you, class.